Our next speaker today went from baling hay and milking cows on a dairy farm in Wisconsin to working as an actress in Hollywood. She's worked on hundreds of films and TV shows like Jimmy Kimmel Live, Young and the Restless, Lizzie McGuire, Drake and Josh, The Suite Life of Zack and Cody, and Malcolm in the Middle. She was a national trainer for L'Oreal Cosmetics, Limited Twos, Passion for Fashion, National Tour MC, and a contestant in the preliminary Miss America pageant. You might have seen her on ABC's Dr. Keith Albo show or heard her on American Family Radio, Washington Watch, or back in the day in Alan Colmes' Fox radio show. This worldwide traveler has opened for bands like Third Day, Colton Dixon, Jeremy Camp, and just spoke at an event with Tucker Carlson. CNS News, WorldNet Daily, Town Hall, and Brio Magazine feature her articles. She's in the midst of launching her Counter Culture Mom podcast with Salem Radio and loves homeschooling her four children, ages 10 and under. Her main mission in life is to expose the lies of the media and inspire people to create change in their culture. Get ready to think outside the box. Please welcome Counter Culture Mom, Tina Griffin.
To be speaking, because before COVID hit, or right when it first began, I didn't know if I'd ever have a chance to share my heart and passion of what's been flowing through my veins for the last 20 years. So, and I know all the speakers here the next 48 hours probably feel the exact same way. We have another chance, another day to share what's on our heart and what we're born with to make a difference. So thank you, Ronnie, for putting this event together. Parents out there tuning in far and wide, please share this content from wherever you are getting this information from, so millions of parents know exactly what's going on in our country during this cover-up situation, which I believe, and we're just going to get right to it, because this is about 10 years of FBI research. When I became a Christian at 16 on a dairy farm in Wisconsin, went out to Hollywood at the age of 20, God basically told me I'm going to be an undercover FBI agent for him. Learn what's going on behind the scenes in pop culture, work on tons of movie sets, TV shows, be a personal driver for Ray Liotta for the Oscars, a ton of different really cool jobs, but I learned a ton. And about 3 or 4 years into that, that's when God's like, okay, it's time for you to share the dirt that you've been uncovering. And so for 17 years, I've been doing a show called Hollywood Exposed around the globe, even with interpreters in different parts of the world. So we're going to get right to it with Robert Pittman, founder and chairman of MTV and iHeart Radio, creator of iHeart Radio. He says, we're dealing with a culture of teenage babies that can watch TV, do their homework, and listen to music all at the same time. The strongest appeal you can make is emotional. If you can get their emotions going, make them forget their logic, you've got them. At MTV, we don't shoot for the 14-year-olds. We own them. This is Robert Pittman. I felt ripped off when I first saw this quote, and I've been sharing it for the last 17 years speaking, and I still get jaws dropping when I do high school assemblies, because teens do not like being lied to. So the second they see who's behind the scenes and who's pumping out this content and why and what their agenda is, they get mad, which I'm glad, because then they start to rip posters off their walls. Back then, break apart CDs. Now they're erasing TV shows and Netflix series are getting canceled, everything. They're saying, I don't want this information in my head any longer if this is what their agenda is to destroy my life. So knowledge is power. We've got 72 hours per week the average teenager spends using the internet, music, cell phones, television, and video games. 38 and a half minutes per week, typical parents participate in meaningful conversation with their kids. Look at how much more influence is actually taking place from pop culture and media, Hollywood. My question is, what are they learning as a result? McAfee survey online security provider says this, 70% of teens hide their online behavior from their parents. How do they do that? By cleaning their browser history, closing browser when parents come in, hiding or deleting instant messages and videos, lying about their online activity, fake profiles, all the rest. And what does this guy say? He is the McAfee security consultant, Robert Siciliano, and founder of IDTheftSecurity.com. He says, parents, you must stay in the know. Since your teens have grown up in an online world, they may be more online savvy than you, but you can't give up. You must challenge yourself to become familiar with the complexities of the teen online universe and stay educated on the various devices your teens are using to go online. That is a must. Now, researching this 40, 50 hours a week while homeschooling my kids, it's hard for me to stay updated on what's going on, let alone the average parent who does not research it 40, 50 hours a week, feels overwhelmed, and like Curtis just says, which was an excellent message, by the way, parents coming up to me at parent events, crying, shaking my shoulders, and telling me, Tina, just tell me what to do. I don't have a time to research, just tell me what to do. And so I'll give you guys solutions towards the end of the program here tonight, this session, on what my husband and I have come up with for solutions, and we now have 15 people on the Counterculture Mom team that are researchers, writers, developers. We have the Counterculture Mom app, which is a must. You have to download that app. We send out push notifications all the time when pop culture is coming out so your kids don't have to ingest and see some horrible content and then have nightmares or eating disorders or suicide tendencies. But the parents actually have the power back in their hands. So that's a good way. Parents feel helpless. So the content out there, we have to know what's going on and what the world is like. Now, what we just heard from Curtis Bowers 2 seconds ago is there is a major communist takeover agenda here on American soil for the last 50, 60 years, like he said. For example, TikTok on July 6, 2020, Laura Ingraham asked Secretary of State Mike Pompeo if families should use TikTok. His response was clear and concise. Only if you want your personal information in the hands of the Chinese Communist Party. This is huge. And this just came out 3 weeks ago. And this is one of the top apps used by kids across America. Personal information, our personal information, going out to the masses, the Communist Party. This is insane. Operation Mockingbird started back in the 50s. Operation Mockingbird is an alleged, it really is this the case, large-scale program of the United States Central Intelligence Agency, the CIA. They began early years of the Cold War, attempted to manipulate news media for propaganda purposes. It funded student and culture organizations and magazines as front organizations, which means they are controlling the major narrative in the mainstream media, which we can see. The other issue we have besides the millions of lies going out on a daily basis from all the major networks, because they're primarily owned by top elites with the New World Order, is the fact that our truthful content is being censored at an all-time high. I just got out of 30 days of Facebook jail again. I'm in jail more than I'm out of it. Anyone here say amen to that? It's like, it's the case. Karen, you've been like posting stuff. I'm surprised you're not in jail right now. It's crazy, the major censorship going on. And the crazy thing is, Bill Gates is the one that funds the fact checker on Facebook. So he doesn't want the truth going on about the mandatory vaccine that's coming up and the Common Core curriculum in schools and the propaganda and the lies of the mainstream media and everything else that his hands are involved in. Look up information on this guy. But because he's pushing Common Core for the last 20, 30 years, he now has millions of young kids now college age and in their early 30s thinking he's a savior. It's all a plot by a few people. For more information on all of that, whole separate subject, I have a Truth Rising Facebook group. You have to get on and join. Thousands of articles. We just formed the group about 3 or 4 months ago, blowing open the lies of Facebook. And surprisingly, Facebook still has us up. Probably no longer now that someone from Facebook is watching this. But get on there, get the news. Our truthful content is being censored at all-time high. But people are waking up. That's the hopeful thing. Because people are just connecting with each other. We do events like this. We're getting creative in how to get the word out. So that's what's going on, major propaganda and major censorship of the truth. There are, like Curtis Bauer has just addressed, the 45 declared goals of the communist movement. Now, I just want to hone in here on three of them. Infiltrate the press. Get control of book review assignments, editorial writing, policy making, positions. Gain control of key positions in radio, TV, and motion pictures. I'm going to be addressing that tonight. Break down cultural standards of morality by promoting pornography, obscenity in books, magazines, motion pictures, all of that, and present homosexuality as basically natural and healthy. So let's take an in-depth look at that. We can see that they are definitely infiltrating American soil with their communist movement. And I believe we have little time left. That's why Satan is on a major attack for the hearts and minds of our younger generation, because the time is ticking and we are in the 11th hour and 59th minute. It's little time left. I believe Christ is coming back in our time. I always felt that since I was 10. I wasn't saved till I was 16. Go figure. But we have little time left. So there's a bunch of stores promoting the homosexual agenda. Now, I definitely believe, I have friends that live that lifestyle. Love the sinner, but just hate the sin. And too many people right now are embracing that as a normal, natural lifestyle. And like Curtis addressed as well, if we allow people to live in sin and not call it what it is, they won't have a chance to have a relationship with Christ. And they will be lost. And so we have to speak the truth in love. And honestly, that is the number one question I'm asked when I do all these youth rallies and open up for Christian bands and travel the country doing leadership conferences. I get flooded with kids coming up asking me, what does God think about homosexuality? And I tell them, because it's an easier way to say it, this is what God says, that it's wrong, that sex is meant between a man and a woman once married. And I have to tell you that truth because I will be judged by God if I would lie to you right now. So my life is on the line. And I'm going to have to face Christ someday. So that lets them see, and then conversations can happen. But with pop culture constantly putting this in our face, it's completely leading millions astray. Gender neutral is a new normal among a bunch of celebrities. It's all over the place. Instagram, Facebook, TV shows, movies. Hasbro CEO just announced we eliminated gender for our toys. This is ridiculous. Any kind of toys that don't go with the godly standards, just got to put them in a backyard and light them on fire and roast a marshmallow over them. Okay, and say bye-bye for now. Not support these companies. 51 gender options for Facebook. You know what it was about a year or two ago? 71 gender options. So maybe we got a Christian now working for Facebook to help lower that number. Maybe get down to 2. Let's keep praying, okay? At least it's progress in the right direction on Facebook on one thing. Gender questioning is one of the options for Facebook. Like, that isn't confusing enough. What is this causing? Major identity crisis. We know that God created man in his own image, and Satan wants to destroy the very foundational beginnings of who we are as humans with Adam and Eve. It blows my mind, but then at the same time, it doesn't surprise me because that's where we are in our culture today. But if we share the truth, I'm telling you, teens, middle school students, so many people, when I go speak places, and I know other speakers would say the same thing, they want the truth. They're starving for it. That's why church pastors tuning into this event tonight, you have to be bold. And if you're currently bold and your church doors are open, that's awesome. If you're not open, open your doors. Now more than ever, we need the churches open in America. People are starving for the truth. And what is God going to say someday? What were you thinking closing your doors when I wanted my church body to be out there helping and witnessing and preaching truth, not living in fear? So open your church doors and let's get active. Worked on a ton of different sets in the past. Malcolm in the Middle, Days of Our Lives. I got to meet MacGyver. He was my crush when I was like 14. Anyone here remember MacGyver? Put a paperclip and some gum together, create a bomb and save 30 people. It was awesome. I'm like, yeah, MacGyver. I like would sing the theme song in the back of my mind 24/7. And then we got Austin Powers, The Spy Who Shagged Me, one of the first sets I worked on. I'm glad no one could recognize me from that set. Dharma and Greg, Lizzie McGuire, a bunch of different really cool movies. But the eye-opening time was when I worked with Brittany Murphy on Little Black Book. We had about a 15-minute conversation to the point where the director came over and said, you guys got to break it up. We're shooting a movie. Let's get back to work. But our conversation basically ended with her telling me this following sentence. Tina, I don't agree with what I'm doing, but I feel like I have to do this in order to get ahead in the industry. I asked her right before this movie, she did 8 Mile, sex, drugs, you name it, in that movie. And she said, are you Tina Marie Live, the one that goes around talking about, you know, pop culture and media influence? This is pre-4 children. Now I'm counterculture mom. And I said, yes. She goes, wow, you got to keep that going. I am a Christian. And I said, do you feel pressured into having to do these roles? Like, how did you feel shooting 8 Mile with the drugs and sex scene? She goes, Tina, I left a set feeling guilty every night. But I feel like I have to do this in order to get ahead. I'm not going to be able to get the next movie role. I won't have the cash that I need. And it just broke my heart because prior to meeting her, I was thinking, how can these celebrities do that? After meeting her, I realized, wow, the number of celebrities that didn't want to do what they were being forced by their directors, their agents in Hollywood. So it really gave me a heart to pray for celebrities. Christ died for all. We need to pray for these celebrities. But at the same time, he also says in Ephesians 5:11, take no part in the unfruitful works of the darkness, but instead expose them. That became my mission in life 17 years ago. Get the dirt and expose what these evil people are up to. Pray for the evil people, but wake up America to let them know that we should not support them with our time and our cash. And if we can, send to their fan address, their fan mail address, a Bible. And many teens have told me over the years, emailing me, sending me video footage, text, whatever, sent Marshall Mathers M&M a Bible with a note. So I have encouraged people throughout time, send a Bible, send an encouraging note to these big celebrities, because if we can get Marshall Mathers saved, we've got about half the globe that might consider that Jesus is actually real. They are such huge influencers. Why am I doing this? Besides trying to get America back on track and get as many people as possible on the road, on the right train to heaven, is to leave my kids with a better America than when I was born. I've got 4 kids, 11 and under now. Levi on the left, Jacob, Eden, and Stella. Stella's 7 going on 14. She's a mini-me, very dangerous. We're going to talk about a couple quick things here tonight. What harmful behaviors is today's pop culture and media promoting? What top resources give solid reviews on today's entertainment? What are some positive entertainment choices available? And how can I stay updated on pop culture and technology news? We've got those 4 main topics. Don't worry about taking notes. Rebecca, you're good. You don't have to take any notes here. text guide, the word guide, to the number 55444. Is anyone watching too? Text the word guide to 55444. You'll get on our newsletter list. You'll get information on how to download our Counterculture Mom app and a 4-page sweet free PDF that is a parent media guide loaded with hundreds of positive entertainment options. Secular media is not going to promote this. We want to make sure that there's a lot of options that are really good. This isn't cheesy stuff from the 80s that I grew up on, embarrassed to tell my friends that I watched a Christian film. These movies are awesome. So, and the TV shows, and the apps, and the comedians, actual funny comedians with clean jokes, they exist. So download that app by texting guide to 55444. We're going to start out with Hollywood hypocrisy tonight. Here's Eminem, Marshall Mathers. He's been out there for 2-3 decades. He says, being a dad is definitely living a double life. I am a firm believer in freedom of speech, but once I hit them gates where I live, that's when I'm dad. Taking kids to school, picking them up, teaching them rules, teaching them wrong from right, best I can, it's like juggling. So he lives in a $4.8 million mansion right outside Detroit, but he has rewritten his lyrics for his own daughter, Haley, to listen to. And that, to me, is unbelievable. In fact, I was on a Focus on the Family cruise about a decade ago. A young girl comes running up to me saying, oh, my gosh, Marshall Mathers, his daughter Haley went to school with me. And she would sing his lyrics. And there was guys in the playground saying, that's not the lyrics to your dad's song. So it just goes to show you that these celebrities are very careful with what their kids are listening to. Madonna sheltered her own kids as well from the magazines that would come into her home, TV shows, social media. There's a lot of celebrities, actually. Counterculturemom.com is my website. I have tons of articles I've been writing for 20 years, many of them on what celebs are actually doing in their own homes. Great parents for their own kids, totally pushing the opposite agenda so they could rake in the millions to live in their mansions. Here's Marshall Mathers, really graphic lyrics in his music. I stab myself with a steel spike while I blow my brains out just to see what it feels like. 20 years of that crazy, wild, graphic content going into young children's minds. And you wonder why there's violence on the street today. There's no value for life because of what they've been pumping their brain. But here's a short little clip.
You have the right to remain violent. Anything I say can and will be used against you.
So he could care less about us, basically. Here's Madonna. I usually speak 90 minutes. Tonight I'm at 45, a new record. Madonna and son Rocco on The Ellen Show. Check this out. She's a great parent for her own kids.
Okay. 12.
So excited.
That's what 12 really is excited. Like. Is your mother strict? Is she a good mother?
Yeah, she's a good mother. But yeah.
But she's what?
She's a good mother, yes. That's why I have to say. She's very strict.
That
but
is very
in
cool.
A good way.
You're on tour with your mother. She can't be that strict. What about when she flashes herself and stuff? How do you feel about that?
I actually don't see that.
He's underneath the stage busy
good.
Doing things.
That's best.
Thanks, Madonna. Under the stage, busy doing things. So she's flashing herself in millions of young children while her son Rocco is under the stage busy. And she's also practically naked on her Instagram posts with millions of young kids that follow her. Here we have Usher from YM Magazine says, decide for yourself whether you're ready or not. Virginity is something to be valued. You're not less hip if you're not having sex. A lot of people are under that impression. That's because of his own lyrics. He's promoting sexuality and sex and a lot of graphic stuff in his lyrics. Don't be pressured into it because you never want to do something that you'll live to regret. So here's his true thoughts on abstinence and virginity, and yet he pumps out the opposite message in his lyrics. TV shows. I'm only going to give you a couple of different TV shows. The Counterculture Mom app, like I said, download it because that is constantly staying up to date. Pop culture is changing. Well, it just changed again. It's nonstop. It is literally nonstop. So this is as of the last 24 to 48 hours of what's going on. TV shows that get Counterculture Mom two thumbs down. Sex Education has been renewed for a third season. I was not happy. Why? Long story short, when I reviewed just the first episode of season one of Sex Education, which came out 3 years ago, I remember calling Luke at work and I'm like, I might have been crying, who knows. The very first 30 seconds of season one, episode one, was the most graphic sex scene between teens I've ever seen. I could handle 5 seconds of it, and I was just like livid. First 30 seconds, mom's making dinner, kids are hanging out, watching a new, everybody's talking about Sex Education, let's check it out. The parent doesn't even have a chance to view the show, check it out, see what's going on, and within the first 30 seconds, Satan threw in a graphic sex scene of Sex Education. This is now in the air for 3 years. Very graphic content. Planned Parenthood is praised in an episode. They gloat about guys giving guys, you can read it on the slide. It's too graphic to mention. I should say before we go any further, because it's going to be some pretty wild content, anyone watching here, tuning in, that's under the age of 13, 14, I would say parents, preview this first. If you're okay with it, then watch it at a later date with your younger kids. I didn't want to dumb it down. I wanted you to show it you exactly what our teens and middle school students are looking at today for entertainment. But if you are keeping your kids safe in your home, great. Be educated, but don't let them see the next following 30 minutes. Lucifer, Satan becomes a consultant for the LAPD, helps punish criminals. This show, I watched two or three episodes, full episodes, and they are leading millions of young people astray. One of the top shows watched by Netflix. I would suggest canceling your Netflix. You'll see a theme of Netflix for the next 5 minutes here, where they make God look like the bad guy. How dare he kick Lucifer out of heaven? How horrible. And the way they do it is very conniving. There's sex, porn, drinking, all of it. They make Lucifer look like the good guy. Netflix renewed for season 6 as of recent. I think like 2 or 3 weeks ago, they just renewed it. Season 4 was released on June 5, all 10 episodes. Usually they have 13 episodes, they just did 10. Some of it's COVID-related. Regardless, 13 Seasons Why, Season 4, was just released a month ago. Millions of young people watch this program. In fact, after Season 1, first episode, Netflix had the most talked about messages going out with teens on social media about Netflix. 11 million shares of their program among the teens just after watching the first episode of Season 1, which tells me it is one of the highest rated shows that teens are watching. Graphic sex, graphic suicide clip after Season 1, it was horrible, very graphic. Teens took their lives as a result. You don't have to show someone a suicide clip in order to talk to them about the dangers of suicide. Sexual assault scenes, vandalism, violence, all throughout that show. Just one of the many victims that took her life, she binge-watched the first season of this program, killed herself April 18, 2017. Anna Bright, American Family Association, did a whole story on this, and that was in the middle of me warning parents, don't let your kids watch 13 Reasons Why. And I could give you 313 reasons why not. I'm sorry, she said, but this has to happen. I love you was the note. She took her life. I won't show the graphic scene, not necessary, but this is a screenshot of the last couple of minutes of season one, last episode of that season, and what millions of kids actually saw. Riverdale season 3. Any young kids? Yes, good for covering the eyes. Riverdale season 3, what's going on there? This is the trailer for Riverdale season 3. Check out what's going on. They are literally promoting baby sacrifice. One of the top shows watched by young kids. Now, watching that trailer, what would that make a young person want to do? Watch the season. Find out, did the babies get dropped in the fire? It's a very dark, satanic program. You definitely want to steer clear from Riverdale season 3. Whenever I show this and do live shows and travel the country and radio program, whatever else, I get a ton of parents saying, I never knew. That's my kids' favorite show. Parents tuning in, preview the shows that your kids want to watch. If your kids are a little bit older and it's a show that we recommend on Counterculture Mom app, then watch it together, have a great discussion over it. There's a lot of positive content that's out there, but these are definitely programs I would say without a doubt steer clear from, even for the adults. A lot of times I'll have people bashing me on social media saying, well, this is supposed to be an adult show. Yeah, but it airs at noon. And even so, what is positive about that show for even a 50-year-old to watch? What are you getting out of that that's making your life better or heading you in the right direction? Do you feel more upbeat or more suicidal as a result? There's a lot of programs that shouldn't be watched by anybody. Here's another one from Netflix. This is Chilling Adventures of Sabrina. Now, one of the first sets I worked on, that's me in the upper left next to that lady in the red jacket, on Sabrina the Teenage Witch. I was not nuts about working on that set 20 years ago when I first got out to Hollywood because of the title of the program. But every time I got on set and had the opportunity to share about the Lord and invite people to church, I was doing that. I would wear abstinence t-shirts on set. You should have heard the conversation back then. What, like, you don't do drugs? No drugs, no sex? What, are you a virgin? Yes, and I'm not the only one in Hollywood. I waited till my wedding night. Was it easy? Absolutely not. And our wedding night, Luke, would you say, was rather short? He took the top part of the cake off and said, we're taking off. You got to do one dance with your family. We're out of here. But it pays to wait. There's blessing in doing it God's way, like Curtis also addressed tonight. But today's pop culture is teaching the opposite message, and many teens are having regrets after doing something that pop culture promoted and the consequences weren't revealed. If you're going to show someone shooting up, getting high, drinking and driving, have the person die or go to AA and getting help. Show us the reality. Somebody's going to make us feel better, get better, positive results. And that's what drives me crazy about today's pop culture in Hollywood. This Chilling Adventures of Sabrina is not the same comedy of Sabrina the TV show. There's seances, Satanism, witchcraft. And believe it or not, they hire witches to work on set. And they were sued by the Satanic Temple because one of their witchcraft scenes in the last season wasn't exactly how it's supposed to be carried out. What? And they lost the case against the Satanic Temple. I had 5 Wiccans trying to take me out at a recent speaking spree last September in Michigan. That was a new one for me. I'll spare you the drama details. But I will tell you that one of them challenged me and said, there's no way they hire witches on set. I said, I got the dirt. I'm going to add it to my show. Thank you for the reminder. So here it is. Here's how detailed they are. Here's the trailer for the show.
Are you willing to forsake the path of light and follow the path of night?
It's very tempting to run. It's very tempting.
I can't do this.
You must.
Millions of young people are watching witchcraft every time they turn on Netflix. Here is Kiernan Shipka on Jimmy Kimmel Live from that show admitting that practicing Wiccans work on set.
Well, we actually have a few writers on our show, a few people who are part of our crew who are practicing Wiccans. So
we do.
So it's nice. You feel like you're making the right moves and doing the right things.
They advise you on the Wiccan stuff.
Yeah, you feel like you have some advisory, which is really nice. We're not all just, you know, doing this and
Do you worry about if you anger them, they will put a spell on you or anything like that?
Yeah, I hope no hexes ever get put on me. That would not be good.
So that gives you, I can skip that one for now. That gives you a good glimpse as to how in depth Satan goes to literally try to take out the younger generations watching these programs. They get it as real as possible. Now, something I want to help you connect the dots with, which I thought was very interesting, Greg Berlanti is the executive producer of Riverdale and The Chilling Adventures of Sabrina. It's literally some of the same people pumping out the same content on all of these networks. Pray for Greg. Netflix's politics under fresh scrutiny after exclusive deal with Obama's to produce content. Barack Obama, which is not his real name, and Michelle, which I won't get into. Do some research, go to Truth Rising Facebook group. Hopefully it's still up there. But there's a lot of lies, even with what I just said. He is totally for the communist movement. So the fact that he is now on Netflix board and helping pump out content does not surprise me that we have the content we're seeing on Netflix. It's very contrived, very controlled, very connected. And what are people doing as a result? Woot woot! Cancellation confirmation, people. I can't tell you how many times I get done speaking on stage in the last couple of years. I'm standing at the booth or hanging out on stage, and I have people coming up to me. Guess who I'm on the phone with right now? I'm like, who? Netflix. They're going down. I just canceled. I'm like, oh, yeah. Luke, get this on camera quick. A lot of people are canceling. That's what we can do. Do you know what we can do about this? Cancel. Don't let the poison come into your home. Close the doors. And now with Common Core curriculum in schools and parents waking up from the last couple of months of COVID, that plan backfired on the leftists, I'll tell you that much, because now parents are actually realizing, what, you're learning this in your curriculum? Uh-uh. I'm homeschooling you guys from now on. And I even have flooded with messages in Facebook, I can't even keep up, a couple hundred a day coming to me, of parents saying, I'm now paying more attention because my kids are home a lot more than normal. I'm paying attention now on what they're watching on YouTube, what they're on there with their social media on their cell phones, what websites they're going to. So it is a time, it is a blessing of a time to reset that parenting button and figure out once and for all, how do I want to raise my kids? And it's never too late. You could have a 16-year-old that's drugs and into sex and everything else. God will give you the right words to speak, the right things to share. And I have a lot of dirt on Counterculture Mom YouTube channel that parents, you have to check out, because you might be trying to get your kids off this grotesque entertainment. You don't know exactly how to say it. I've got the proof on there. Hundreds of videos of celebrities admitting what they're doing is wrong. Different shows that I've done. Teenagers that have changed their media habits. Check out the Counterculture Mom YouTube channel. Hopefully that'll stay up there. And get that information. Watch it with your kids and have a great discussion after. So what's happening as a result? Because of all this content pumping the airwaves, we have millennials are now ditching religion for witchcraft and astrology. But at the same time, knowledge is power. Get the truth out there. Things will change. Positive entertainment is in. It really is in. We just need more of it. So we have Blue Bloods, Shark Tank, Food Network. Now, I love, you know, watching food and eating food, and I married Luke because he knows how to make food. I do most of the cooking, but I have like three things left in the fridge. I'm calling him, high alert, please make a buffet out of what we got in here. That's what won me. I'm like, you're single, right? Because you just cooked an amazing meal. And he's like, yep. I'm like, we're getting married. Because I love to eat. Shark Tank, whenever we watch those episodes, granted because of COVID, just to let everybody know, there's a lot of programming that's halted right now. But there's a blessing in that as well, because of these 95% of the junk coming out of Hollywood is poison for our kids anyway. They're not able to shoot. And my husband just started a brand new film company with two other guys called Triptych Media. It is phenomenal. They're going to be, they have 7 feature films in the works right now, but they're pumping out positive content that platforms that do streaming can show. And the cool thing is people are going to be watching it because the junk from Hollywood is no longer going to be pumping out the junk because of COVID. Another way that this plan of action from the elites backfired. Oh yeah. Let's see if I can get 3. Okay, so sportsmanship, leadership, teamwork, self-sacrifice, family values, creativity, innovation, all of it from these shows. Now, America's Got Talent, fun show. There's a couple of times where people are lost and need the Lord, forget to put some clothes on. They're a male trying to be a female. Just a couple of times where I'm like, kids, turn away, fast forward. But for the most part, it's been some really neat winners in the last couple of seasons. Even young kids, 10, 11 years old, with great talent. Little House on the Prairie, that never gets old. We have all the DVDs from like 1920. And we watch those with our kids. And it's just great, positive entertainment coming back in our home. Focus on the Family has Adventures of Odyssey. And there's so many. Counterculture Mom app and The Guide by texting Guide to the number 55444 will give you a lot of positive content to replace the junk that might be in your home. And I'm currently in the process of starting a Pop Culture Purge, really cool ebook that's going to help parents go through the process of ditching the junk in their home. And I have a TV show series and about 10 other projects, but hopefully the rapture won't happen quite yet because I'm not quite done. But hopefully it'll happen sooner than later. Most followed female Instagram user with 146 million followers is Ariana Grande. God is a woman. I just want to talk about this song for a minute. 2 thumbs down for the music. Back in 2018, I took this screenshot because I want to let America know in God is a Woman video, she literally is mocking Jesus by sitting where he sat at the supper table with all the disciples, and they're not honoring God. They're doing the exact opposite. Total blasphemy. Bottom left, Michelangelo painting with God reaching down to man. What did she do? I love this kind of stuff. I will go through the music videos, and at the very end, there was a shot that was rather quick. I rewinded it, paused it, and she had herself in that very same mock-up painting as if she is reaching down to a woman, as if she's God. Wild. She also gives a lot of her proceeds to Planned Parenthood. A lot of her proceeds. Go to concerts, dances around half naked, tells young girls, go ahead and be promiscuous and have sex, not a big deal. Of course, then the young girl's going to Planned Parenthood and millions of dollars are being made on aborting that live, living baby in the womb. And she's even taking those proceeds from that young girl in the audience and giving it to Planned Parenthood. It's a nasty, evil process. Pray for Ariana. Not that she can't come to the Lord. But we just had Kanye West post this on social media. I cried at the thought of aborting my firstborn, and everyone was so concerned about me. I'm concerned for the world that feels you shouldn't cry about this subject. There are celebrities that are turning to Christ, and the impact that they can have on the globe is huge. So pick a celebrity. People tuning in, people in the audience tonight, pick a celebrity and pray for them. Forever, for every single day we've got left on the earth. Everybody pick a celebrity and pray for them. Because if we can get the celebrities saved and led to the Lord, which is why I even went out there to begin with, we can have a huge impact on the rest of the globe. The rock sign. I always wondered what this meant, so I did some research. A lot of celebs do the rock sign. This is an older picture of Kanye, so he has changed his ways. But I want to show you what it means, because a lot of celebrities still flash it. They form a pyramid to show that the few rule the many. These people claim they're at the top of the power structure. They shape our worldview. Rihanna, Drake, Ellen, another shot of Drake. Tom Cruise, when I saw that, I'm like, come on, Tom? He's majorly into Scientology. And pray for him. And then we go back a little bit further, we got Hitler. Interesting. We have this symbol. all over pop culture, album covers, t-shirts, magazine covers, CD album covers, all over. This sign is the Pledge of Allegiance to Satan. When it is given over the eye, it represents the eye of Lucifer, literally. And there are thousands of celebrities. In fact, I do this in a high school assembly. I'm surprised I still was able to, I'm just shocked. I'll get flooded with people saying, hey, here's some more dirt. Because when kids see this, they're like, hang on a second. Either I keep believing the lie or I change and make better decisions on who I follow and who I want to listen to and have that message pump in my brain. And they'll send me more dirt that I just go ahead and share with the masses. And then we have tons of positive music, a lot of great trending videos on YouTube. Counterculture Mom app is loaded with those as well. These are some of the top songs that have been out there now for the last week or two, top of the charts. A lot of great music. Once again, the liberal side of our country, the mainstream media, don't promote the positive. But if you sit and listen to one negative song and figure out and tune into how you feel physically, and then you listen to a positive song and how you feel, if we can get these kids to switch over, it's like eating Cheetos for 21 days in a row. You have a heart attack, your arteries clog, and you collapse on the floor. You give them a couple of positive entertainment options and do a pop culture purge in your home, you will see a night and day difference because you're closing the door to any kind of satanic junk coming into your home. And now that we're in quarantine, it'll make the job even easier. They don't have outside influence. They're not going on the school bus. They're not inside the schools. Chance the Rapper goes on hiatus to study the Word of God. This is another lost celebrity in the pressure of the satanic agenda in Hollywood that said, you know what? I'm turning to God. And he had thousands of people tuning in on social media when he was reading the Word of God. I thought that was so cool. So we have to be praying for these people. How do you stay in contact with me? Well, connect for sure. CountercultureMom.com is the website. Download the Counterculture Mom app. We have a brand new app that launched 2 weeks ago. I love it, love it, love it. We're adding more content all the time to it. So, of course, middle of the night, Luke's like, would you go to bed? And I'm like, well, I have about 10 more things I want to add to the app. Can you get up now and put them in there before I forget? pop culture alert notifications. That's my favorite section. We sent a survey out. A bunch of people responded. We had this app up now for 2 years. And all of the great content that we gathered from the survey of what they want in this app, we then put in the brand new app that just launched again the second time. There's booking info on there, school, church, camp, parent event, and now online events. If you want this actual show, Hollywood Exposed, text that, no spaces, to 55444. And then once again, text the word guide to 55444 to get all of the positive, top, clean content that we've done research over. So if you have to do a load of laundry for 45 minutes, you don't have to worry about some nasty commercial break in between some of these programs. Like, we've already filtered it, checked it out, and these are safe places to go. And if you know of some great spots that you and your family have already tried and love, send it over to us, info@counterculturemom.com. All that information is on our website, counterculturemom.com. And then we'll add it to our free parent media guide. We're always updating it. Here's a brand new app, a couple of quick features. We have pop culture alerts, a news feed. So if busy parents are like, I don't even know what news sources to trust, Tina. Just where do we go? How do we look that up? I don't have a lot of time. Just tell us what's going on. The news feed just pumps out daily from different websites, credible news sources, uncensored information that's actually going on. We pump it right through the app so you can quickly scroll through it and say, you know what? These two pertain to my family. The rest don't. But at least you have it coming to you. And you don't have to worry about going to the 70 or 80 websites that we do weekly to go through all of that to figure out what is the top news story that's impacting the most families in America. And then our pop culture alerts, I already shared about what that was, with the current apps that are coming out, movies coming out, TV shows, magazines, books, both stuff you want to run from and stuff that you want to gravitate and grab and watch with your family. A lot of stuff is free on there, too, that we offer. If there's a free link to watch a movie ahead of time, we just let you guys know about it. Parent chat is also a major awesome section that I put in there. If there's certain people in a certain part of the country that have already helped pass a law or talk to their congressman about fighting whatever battle it is, or some school situation, or jump on a school board, or another, and there's people on the other side of the country that want that same thing to happen over there, instead of doing all the legwork, we're connecting the people. People in Washington that got that problem solved, people down in Florida need help, we connect the two on this parent check section. We got a parent in Wisconsin whose teen is heavily into drinking and drugs, and we've got a parent down in Texas that helped get their kid safe and help their kid with the addiction. We connect through parent chat these two parents. So the one in Texas can help the one in Wisconsin. So that's what we've been doing, is building this whole section out so parents can connect with each other. We also have, this is the Pop Culture Alerts example of some great information you want to check out, like Selfie Dad just came out, awesome, clean movie, totally promoting father in a great light. Woo, woo, got one out there. Dear friend Shonda Pierce is in that one. And then we have Check Your Apps That May Be Sharing Private Information. That's, of course, an alert type deal that you want to watch out, what are your kids involved with. Very short alerts. Parents don't have 20 minutes to read an article. They've got 3 minutes. Problem? And we always end with a solution. Who to call, who to ban, who to address our concerns, or where do we go to get that positive content? What website do we go to? That kind of thing. And then we have featured educators. We're adding four more in the next 3 days. Very, very excited. One on finances. I'm working on one with fashion, social media guru, and there's this guy, Jason from Axis. Amazing content. So we're adding four new people to the featured educators on different topics to help you in your home. You can even get it on your watch. Pretty cool. Hollywood Exposed, we have a brand new series that came out. It's for download or physical copy. It's $40. You can go to counterculturemom.com, click on the store tab, get your hands on that. This goes through a lot of information, 4 hours of content. I promise you, you'll not be bored. I just got a text a couple weeks back from a teen that listened to the entire thing and said, "Where's more?" And the mom chimed in and said, "I can't believe that he actually listened to the entire 4 hours." And it was really good meat information. I don't do fluff. And I go into detail about what I witnessed firsthand by working on movie sets, celebrities I've witnessed, homes I went into, what I saw, jobs that I said no to and why, pedophiles that are currently in Hollywood. There's a lot of content happening that parents need to be aware of. And we have at our store on counterculturemom.com a brand new summer survival pack. This thing is awesome. It's $110 worth of goods for $69. I partner with Animo Bible Verse Game. They have a booster pack. It's a really cool card game that promotes scripture, and my kids love it. So I partner with them. You get the new Ford CD series in there, rock and roll DVD, the 3-hour DVD. You want to have someone over, your neighborhood kids over, have them watch that. That will change their life on the music industry and why it's so important to choose positive entertainment. There's celebrities in there admitting things that I just shared tonight. 3 hours long, great DVD. Parent chat book, Armed and Dangerous book, it's loaded. So check it out at the store. And if you want to be a part of this, we are a nonprofit. You can text donate to the number 55444. I don't take a dime from that comes in, either honorarium for speaking or if it's money that comes in through a donation. It comes to our nonprofit through Capstone Legacy Foundation, and from there, I pay my staff a fee. I can tell you right now, I need about 5 more people on the team to do what we need to do. So right now, if you text donate to 55444, we will use it to grow our team, to get more content through the app into your home to help you out. There's a lot of things you can do with the talents that you've got. I just want to encourage you guys, ask God with the little time that we've got left, and I believe it's little, exactly what he wants you to do with the talents you were born with to make a difference. You're never too old. You're not too poor. God, if he gives you a vision, he is going to make a way for you to do exactly what he's called you to do. And honestly, right now, I want to get America back on track with morality, family structure, honoring our flag, honoring our soldiers, honoring our cops, honoring our president in office and our vice president. What do you think this flag stands for? Freedom. We have it. Every other nation wants it. And the communist agenda is to burn that down and destroy our country from within. And as long as I'm alive on this earth, and I know you in the audience and you watching from home, not on my watch. Not on my watch. I'm willing to die for the cause of Christ. I'm willing to die to get this country back on track. And if I die, I want my kids witnessing, Mom did everything she could, Dad did everything he could to make a difference with the time that we have. We're all soldiers. We need to band together, not cause division, and not let the enemy win. We know God wins in the end. And if God is in us and we're a born-again believer, we need to get busy and get off the bench. And if you don't know the Lord, get to know the Lord. Find a friend who's a believer. Ask Jesus to come into your heart and mind. Admit you're a sinner. Repent. Our church needs to repent in America. That's where I'm at. Willing to die for the cause. Thank you so much, you guys. CounterCultureMom.com. Let's get out there and make a difference.
There is nothing in this world more precious than a child. We treasure the immeasurable value and undeserved gift of children. God calls on all of us to protect the minds of our children from those who regard them as commodities. Marxist indoctrination, sex trafficking, and the enticement of the pop culture industry are crimes being committed against our children even as we speak. And that's why we are here. Would you join us in an effort to rescue them? Text the word rescuing to 50155 to donate any amount. Thank you.